Hi guys, Philip English, Innorobo 2016. So we've got a new stand, we've got the Kinova stand. We've got a gentleman here who's just going to introduce himself and he's going to tell us a little more about his robots.
Hello, I'm Jerome Bedard, a product specialist at Kinova Robotics. Firstly, Kinova Robotics was founded in 2006, near Montreal, in fact, in Canada. At first, the arm JACO was created for people in power wheelchair as an arm that would be fit on the power wheelchair to help to grasp daily the object. So for that reason, the arm that we created was really small and mostly light in width, so the lightness, and also low in power consumption. So that was the first thing that was invented in 2006, and first sell was maybe 2010.
Okay.
Yeah. So from there, since we have a really special product, really small compared to traditional, let's say, industrial robots that are more really stronger and faster and heavier, we were really different from the other standard robots. So we decided to open the perspective of our product, and then we started to meet new people, especially in research and in logistic application. And the demand for a robot continued, and people wanted even smaller robots, and then we invented Miko, even smaller. And that was a new way of seeing the robotic, even for us and for people. Like, okay, so a robot now can be a really safe and simple robot instead of just being dangerous, maybe, yeah. Like an automotive kind of a way of seeing robotics. So that was the first thing, and then we continue to put, for example, torque sensor in every joint of our robot. So now we can do what we call torque control. We can move the robot around, and when it touches something, it will stop. So that's the kind of innovation that we're doing right now.
Ways to get it. Yeah, so what I'll do is I'll put in some videos of the robot like getting moved around in a minute. So what's the main difference between JACO and Micro, like strength-wise and speed-wise and weight-wise?
Both have 20 centimeters a second, so they're really not fast robot, to be honest. It's mainly the reach. JACO has 90 centimeters
right.
And of reach, and Miko 70.
Right, okay.
But what is interesting is that they both have the same weight, let's say 4.5 kilogram.
Yep.
But JACO is bigger because it's in fiber, carbon fiber.
Right, I see.
Also, the payload.
Yep.
JACO is at full reach is 1.5 kilogram.
Right.
And Miko is 1 kilogram.
Okay.
But it's interesting because the reach is longer, but the payload is still bigger.
The
bigger reason for that is the second actuator is for JACO is really, really stronger. It's a, so there's not much difference. And actually, just the way we see robotic at Kinova, it's also, we have products that are really modular in kind of,
right.
It all comes through the actuators that we sell as well. So it's possible for people, for example, to buy a JACO and, okay, put some, remove the last two joints and
yeah.
Change something there. So it's possible to put another kind of actuator at the end. So it's possible to go that way. So we sell those two robots,
okay. But
you can also customize it in a way.
So could you extend it out? So could you have like a JACO and then you add a few more links so he's even longer arm? Is that possible?
That would be possible, but of course it always goes to the payload that you can add, of course. That's but for example, we had some people just getting the Miko,
okay.
And it added a fifth link. Because we also sell the version in 4DUF. Those are 6DUF version, but it's possible
okay.
to have this in 4DUF version.
Right,
so it's possible to buy a 4DUF and let's say upgrade it in 5DUF, see how many joints you need for your specific task. So that's one thing that's possible. But of course, the longer reach you go, the payload.
The more of a stretch. So you got JACO, you got Micro. Is there another one that you guys are developing, or are those your two key products?
We're still developing, of course. Maybe like in 1 year and a half, we'll have our third version, because this is already the second version of our robot.
Right, okay.
Maybe a third version, we with even more precision and repeatability on the actuators with a new version of actuators. All goes to this. I could have this in my hand, is the actuators. That's the technology that Kinova developed itself. Okay. And the new generation is going to be a bit stronger, precise. That's so the thing. And then with this, we'll be able to do a new robot as well.
That sounds great. I mean, I think that's a brilliant like overview. Yeah, of obviously like Kinova and their two robots. So, like, thanks very much for your time.
My pleasure.